Howdy, YouTube family. It's Bolt sRNA coming to you again with another day's topic. Today, we're going to talk about what is the perfect job for a new graduate. So let's get into it. As I approach the end of my third year here and I'm getting ready to graduate and move on to my first job, I've already signed a contract somewhere, so I kind of already know where I'm going. But other people are wondering, like, what should they look for in their first job? What kind of things should they be asking? What kind of questions should they be talking about in the interview? What kind of jobs are good for a new graduate? Being a new graduate CRNA is kind of a tricky situation because you are a fully licensed independent anesthesia provider, and you've been in training for years, and you've done thousands of hours of clinicals, and you should feel well prepared for any situation that could come your way. But if you're wise, you also understand that there's a ton of stuff you still don't know just because you're not gonna know everything in a few years of anesthesia training. You will learn so much in your first year of practice from what everyone's told me. And back from my RN days, my first year in the ICU, I can see how that's so much true, because your first year out of nursing school, I mean, nursing school training and education is very different from CRNA training and education, let me clarify. But even still, when you got out of your RN training and began your first job as a new nurse, especially as a new nurse in the ICU, that's very overwhelming. I mean, I'm sure you all remember that first year, especially as you step out of nursing school and you're just totally overwhelmed. And you're dealing with critical care patients, you have patients with intra-aortic balloon pumps, you have continual renal replacement therapies, you know, cycling patients' blood outside their body 24/7, and you know that if you let the machine stop, or if you let the line clot, or something like that, you can end up transfusing like a ton of blood clots right back into their body and kill the patient or something. You could cause so much harm in the ICU as a new graduate, and it's terrifying as a new grad because you realize you're responsible for two patients' lives every day who are critically ill, whose bodies are trying to actively die on you, and it's your job to make sure it doesn't happen and to use medication therapies and to use assessment skills and all of these critical thinking things that you develop. Honestly, you really develop as a nurse. You don't develop it very much in nursing school. You have to develop it very fast in the ICU as a new grad. So that first year, very overwhelming and in the ICU. So I would say it's similar as a CRNA, not that you're prepared much, much better and pretty extensively in CRNA school, but there's still that element, I'm sure, of when you step out of clinicals and you're licensed under your own name and you're taking care of patients on a very intense level like anesthesia, where things can go wrong at any time. You know, that's the rule with anesthesia, is 95% of the time it's boring, which is good. You want it to be boring because that means the patient's alive and safe. But then like 5% of the time, things are not boring. Things go wrong, and they go wrong very fast. And I've seen it happen multiple times in my own training over the last 2 years. And it's very scary, and it's very impressive when you see an experienced CRNA or an experienced physician anesthesiologist jump in and use their training and their experience to like fix issues quickly. And that's what's required of you to be an anesthesia provider. So that first year out, just the idea that any random thing that happens to that patient under your care is your responsibility, and you are expected to fix it and quickly. And it could mean the patient's life or death. So yeah, as a new graduate, the type of job that I would say would be best for you is one where you will have the ability for mentorship while you're there. You wanna be looking for a job where you will have someone around who wants to mentor you and wants to take you under their wing and has good experience. You know, you don't want to be going somewhere where everyone's all new graduates pretty much, and there's like one experienced person and they're trying to like help out everybody all at once. That's not a good pick. But you also don't want to go somewhere where it's heavily restricted and you're kind of put into a little box and told like, you can't perform this skill, you can't do epidurals, you can't do regional anesthesia, you're not allowed to put in central lines, you may or may not occasionally get to do an arterial line, you just do the intra-op portion, you don't do any pre-ops or PACU management or anything like that. You don't want to ever go anywhere like that, because then you'll just stagnate. Then you're kind of like crippling yourself right out of your training, which is when you should be, you know, strengthening yourself the most and getting your, you know, feet the strongest planted on the ground. Instead, you're just kind of like kicking your feet up and taking it easy when you should be like really getting the strongest that you should be. And then I've talked to quite a few CRNAs who just took positions like that because for various reasons, whether they just wanted a lifestyle position or they just didn't know any better, or maybe they just didn't feel confident in their skills or were afraid of being independent or practicing all their skills. And they just took a job that disabled them. And then they got, you know, 3 years out of school and into practice and realized like they're miserable and they have been disabled and they're not happy because they know they're being disabled and they don't feel confident enough to step out on their own now because it's been 3 or 4 years since they've ever done an epidural or since they ever did any regional anesthesia or since they ever put a central line in somebody. So now they feel like it's been too long since they've done it at all and they don't feel confident taking a good position now. So those are not good positions for new graduates to go into. I would never recommend people taking jobs like that. You want a job that is going to offer you the ability to perform all of your skills that you're trained and licensed to do, while also having some mentorship around. You don't want to be somewhere where it's like every man for themselves and everybody's just gonna, you know, run around and do their own thing and everybody's gonna ignore you and just say, you know, toughen up and get with the program. Because I don't care how tough you are, as a new person in the field, you need somebody around who is kind of experienced and can like give you a helpful advice and mentorship. I mean, we all understand what mentorship is. Mentorship is not holding someone's hand or telling you what to do or directing you or anything like that. It's just being an experienced person who cares about your progress and success in the future. And you want someone like that around in your practice. And that's important as a new graduate. So I recommend finding a job that is large enough where you have someone around, at least one person, who is willing to be kind of a mentorship role to you and to help you out. Also allows you to practice. Also allows you to do anesthesia and to perform and use critical thinking and use your own brain and make your anesthetic plan and do all the things that you were trained and licensed to do so that you don't kind of stagnate and your brain doesn't, you know, kind of atrophy a little bit by not performing any of these skills. So that is my idea of the best job for a new grad. All right, guys, so that is everything about a new grad job that I can think to talk about. If you have any questions about it specifically, you can comment below. You can also go over to my Instagram, which is BoltSRNA. You can follow me over there. I'm pretty active on that. Message me, whatever. I'm very good about getting back to people as fast as possible on messages and stuff. And I think that's everything. So that's Bolt out.